get a door unlocked, so it's live on RCTV. Steve Cook will be taping for us tonight presenting. This is a continuance meeting of the public hearing for the 186-190 Summer Ave. And I guess I'll ask if it's not all this something I could present so we know where we're standing.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Blodgett. For the record, I'm Ken Bargolin. I'm the attorney for Criterion Child Enrichment, Inc. My law office is at 246 Walnut Street in Newton. Let me give you an overview of what we will be presenting this evening. It will not be lengthy, but I think it will be positive. You'll hear from Mickey Krokmalnik, and he's going to show images of the doors that we would propose to replicate for the two new doors. We'll also show pictures of the windows that we would propose to place, and the period-appropriate light poles that you had requested. Please remember that any changes that we make in the plan that CPDC approved will be subject to CPDC approval, and I'll come back to that. The importance of that in a couple of minutes. You'll hear from Jack Sullivan, and we received from Attorney Miaris a list of the recommendations of this commission. And I just want to go over them one by one and let you know how we propose to meet them. And we've met, again, subject to CPDC approval, I believe, with about all of them, but one possible exception. First of all, in terms of the parking spaces closest to Summer Ave, we will be proposing to take the first four spaces, those are non-handicap spaces, and moving them to the rear, Area C, as we've called it. We don't propose to move any of the four handicap spaces because there's no ADA accessible entrance in the rear of the barn because there are some stairs there, and so the four handicap spaces will be closest to the handicap accessible entrance to the facility. I hope that won't pose a problem for you. If it would, then I specifically request that you allow those spaces to remain where they are as a reasonable accommodation under the Americans with Disabilities Act, but I hope we don't have to get there. In terms of the circular drop-off, that is not something that we would be willing to do. We went over it with Jack Sullivan, and as he can explain, it poses problems with snow removal, with space, and this is not really a drop-off facility. People primarily pack and stay for the time period that they're within the facility. as Jack will explain and show you on revised plans, we will be using a pervious pavement as extensively as the CPDC will allow, and Jack will show you where we propose to use it. There can be, and I think you have on the plans, Jack, some screening for some of the parking spaces that would be visible from Summer Ave, is that correct?
That's correct.
So we will do some vegetative screening, which we think will look very nice. In terms of reducing the width of the driveway, from 24 to 20 feet, we do propose to do that, and we understand that the fire chief agrees with that. Now, he can't speak for the entire CPDC, but we don't believe that will be a problem. We were asked to put trees along the right side of the travel portion of the driveway, and I have to say, although we believe that is outside of the Historic District Commission's jurisdiction, and we don't waive any of our rights to insist that this commission remain within its legal authority, we will put those trees where I think it was Mr. Williams suggested, and Jack will show you that those trees on the right side, and I think they will create the effect that, again, I think it was Mr. Williams suggested would be a visually positive effect. So we do intend to do that, again, subject to CPDC approval, because they had approve the landscaping plan. Lastly, in terms of the I think as you called it, the signage clutter, I think we all agreed that the stop sign towards the entrance exit needs to stay. There were no parking signs. I think there were four visible from Summer Ave. We were requested to place those signs to the right of the driveway. I believe it was by the police chief at the CPDC. However, we're more than willing to remove them, or perhaps make them smaller. That would be up to the CPDC, but any issue with those signs would not come from criteria. So we're going to show you tonight a proposal, especially when we remember that we're saving and preserving and rehabbing the two historic structures, which I think is a remarkable proposal, which meets as many of the concerns of this commission as we can feasibly meet. And what I will be asking at the end of the evening, I'll tell you now so it's no surprise, I'm going to ask a decision, a positive decision. I'm sure you may have some conditions in that decision, but what I would propose, and I think I did this in my proposed decision, to try to get this done, that anything that would require us to return to the CPDC, I would propose a decision which approves our submission, subject to CPDC approval, but as to any elements which the CPDC will not approve, because we can't read their minds, this commission then approves the submission as is. That would avoid a ping-pong effect, because we do have to go back to the CPDC with the changes we're suggesting before this commission. I'm assuming you'll talk to Mr. Miaris, your counsel, about that, but that would be my proposal is the most efficient way to proceed. And one last thing, I want to stay strictly on a positive note. In the unlikely, to my mind, event that we had to appeal, we're not withdrawing the original proposal with these revised suggestions. We're leaving them in place in case we had to appeal. But we think that the revisions meet your concerns, and we'll leave this with an absolutely stunning proposal, which we hope will now meet your approval after these three hearings. So with that, I'm going to turn things over to Mickey Krakmalnik, who you know, our architect.
We were talking about windows. In fact, we will maintain all of the existing windows. They will be repaired in place where necessary. Furthermore, we will keep all of the existing storm windows, with some exceptions, and I will show. So I have this slide. This is an exterior window with a storm window behind it, okay? Those will be kept in place, will be repaired as needed. Regarding the existing storm windows.
Hold on for a second.
Yeah, no, I'm sorry.
They're going to leave the balcony and go down to
regarding the existing storm windows, as I say, we'll keep them all with the exception out of the 31 such windows. We will keep them with the exception of six that have been changed in time to not align their muntins like here with the muntins of the window behind that we will preserve. As such, with a storm window like this one, or like this one, or like this one, these are three examples of the sack of the six around the house that we intend to replace and replicate, actually, with one that replicate in kind, with keeping the swinging contraption at the top. This is one example where a storm window is missing. There are two of them, and we will here replicate again storm window. Here the contraption continue to exist. This is another one, another of the six that are misaligned. It's, you know, on the north facade, it's another one. I don't, and this is on the east facade. It's, you know, it's very obvious how different is this one compared with this one. Having said that, next we will go to the new doors. One new door will be on this side of the non-historic annex, where we intend to simply replicate this this door here, which seems a logical thing to do, given the fact that there are two similar ones and there will be a third one there. I remind the commission that on the east facade of the barn, there will be one new door and two new windows at the basement level of the barn. What we intend to do is to replicate this existing door that that is on the south facade of the barn, to replicate it and use it on the east side. This is a view of the interior view of that. Lastly, the two new windows at the basement of the barn on the east, we will do them identical to the historic windows on the third floor of the house. The proportion is slightly different, but the size is very similar. So these will be, again, replicas. The last thing are these five existing former hay openings that are now blocked on the inside by with plywood, as you can see here. This is one of the five. We will replace the plywood with glass from the inside. There will be no change in appearance on the outside. Lastly, on the south, on the east facade of the barn, the one facing the school driveway, this we will replace here in place the window that existed here with a replica of the other window on its right. We have been in contact with a number of manufacturers of this kind of historic or special windows and doors, and they indicated that they can be replicated. One name that I can offer is the company name Architectural Components Inc. that has a business in Montague, Massachusetts, a town that few people might have heard about. This is what I wanted to show separately. There's been in Attorney Miaris's seventh point a note about light, the outdoor light fixtures. We intend, there are literally tens, maybe hundreds of examples of such things that can be selected from. I just picked up two simply to illustrate this photo. This example I took because the house behind is not unlike in style and probably age with the 186 Summer F. So much about this. We, as requested, we will find the appropriate period light poles to be located on the property. With this, we go to the important issues of site that Jack Sullivan will discuss.
Okay, hold on. In terms of the lighting, we would ask, so because we can't obviously read your minds, and there are an unlimited number of types, if you all want as a condition something different than was shown, simply specify with enough specificity so we can find it and place it, because we will be needing a decision. And again, we can't read your mind. We think those look appropriate and consistent with the architecture, but we would abide by your ruling on that, provided the CPDC approved. Jack, I'm gonna ask Jack to show the site. One thing I didn't mention, and Jack will be showing this, in making revisions to the site, the grade issue just about disappears. I think all the grades within 6 to 8 inches of the existing now. So that's another improvement and another concern of this commission that's been met. So go ahead, Jack, please.
Yep. I will show you the site plan, correct, Jack?
Yes, please.
The new proposed site plan. Oh, apologies. All right. You have a pointer?
Yes, I do, yeah. Hey, for the record, my name's Jack Sullivan. I'm with the Sullivan Engineering Group. So just to follow up what Ken stated, is there were changes made to the driveway width. You can see there'll be a 20-foot driveway. Previously, there was 24. There'll be no curbing on this side of the driveway.
Is it the right or left?
On the left.
Okay.
On the left. There'll be no curbing from the back of sidewalk to the first parking space. There will be no curbing on the right-hand side,
yep,
from the back of sidewalk all the way back to what we're calling parking area C.
No curb?
No curb. Okay. And to give a little background, what I did is I had two conversations this week. I spoke to the town engineer. Like I told the commission before, I had come in previously with porous pavement as my main design for the entire site previously, and the town engineer had a concern where I was using it for the entire site, but he said he has no problems with allowing a mix of the porous pavement and then conventional. So what I made a decision on is from Summer Avenue back to parking area C will all be porous pavement. By doing that, I don't need the curbing on the right-hand side. I don't need the curbing up until I hit the first parking space. Anywhere there's a walkway, I need curbing, which makes sense. If you have a car pulling in, you need something to stop them so that they don't go onto a walkway. So there will be vertical granite curbing from this point right along the parking spaces and along the left-hand side of the driveway. Okay. We'll still have the concrete walkway. CPDC wanted this positive connection to the Summer Ave sidewalk, so pedestrian traffic could walk up this walkway and access the building. One thing I should note for the curb cut, as consistent with the other driveways along Summer Avenue, there'll be granite curb corners. Okay, they're 2-foot granite radius stones. That would be the only curbing, and that's just at this opening here. That's consistent with all the other driveways along this stretch. That's a standard the town looks for. You can see, I want to point out one thing. We talked about providing some trees, and I picked 3 species of trees, one the ginkgo, one a red oak, and one little leaf linden to be planted. I should note there's some large pine trees here that all along we were proposing to retain, but they are pine trees. So to try to mimic the look of the corridor of Summer Avenue, we're providing these 3 species of trees to be planted 30 feet on center, moving back. And I also propose 3 on this side of the driveway on the left-hand side as well. To attempt to screen the parking spaces from Summer Avenue, there'll be 3 arborvitaes that will be 6 feet high when planted here. Okay. As I stated, this will all be porous pavement up to this point, and then we go to a conventional, a traditional paved parking lot. There'll be vertical granite curbing throughout this parking lot because we will have a drainage system in there consisting of catch basins, storm scepters, and an underground infiltration field, just like we previously had proposed. I do want to note as well is when I look, there's some nice street trees at the existing, at the proposed curb cut, and proposing a ginkgo tree right here as well in the tree line. Figured that would complete the look and provide an additional planting along the public way. Could you go up to the grading plan? And as Ken stated, there were in the previous version, there were four parking spaces in this area that we relocated to parking area C, back here.
Jack, what will be where the four will be taken?
And so there'll be the three arborvitaes that we plant here. There'll be some trees, and this will be a grass area here, which is consistent with what would be in front of the main building to Summer Abbott's, a grass area. I should note that there was a light post about in this area here that I removed, okay? So now there'll be three lights. There'll be one here, and there'll be one back here, and one back here. So we took it from four to three. What I want to show on the grading plan, it'll be a little difficult for everyone to see, but I regraded the entire walkway, driveway, ADA walkways, this whole back portion with the playground areas. I did a total regrade. By allowing the porous pavement from this point to this point, I'm able to match the grades within 6 to 8 inches throughout. Okay? And then when I get back to this area, remember previously we had like a 4 foot drop from the top of curb to the existing ground. Now I have a 6 inch drop. So with the porous pavement, I matched the grades and then graded this out as such that we're really basically meeting the grades in the back now. It's still basically the same layout as we saw before. There's still the turnaround for the fire department. We still have the same snow storage area. The four spaces in the back, I know we talked about, or at least I talked about exploring some different surfacing options for the parking and driveway areas. And after talking with the town engineer, I made the decision that I would do the porous pavement in the front, conventional pavement in the back, and I eliminated the idea of the turf stone. My idea is I'm creating a low point back here where I'm gonna put a catch basin, and then I'm gonna put a storm scepter, some underground infiltration here. And I just wanted, if I was going to go with a conventional drainage system in the back, I felt it best to keep pavement throughout. The more I thought about the turf stone, it can work. If the commission would really like to see turf stone with grass, we can do it. But also, if cars are parked there, antifreeze or oil drips from the car, with my paved surface, it will run to the catch basin, then go to a storm scepter. Where it removes any total suspended solids or oil, and then water moves out to my infiltration field. With the turf stone, it would just go into the ground. So the more I thought, it's only for four spaces, it's probably not a big issue. I'll leave it up to the commission. If you wanted to see an open turf stone for those four spaces, we can. Otherwise, I suggest we just keep it the traditional pavement. And there may be a question, see how I stack these parking spaces? These parking spaces will be employee-only parking spaces. I've done this on some other sites in town where trying to save natural site features. What I try to do here is instead of putting another 24-foot access with parking off and maybe removing more of the trees and losing more open space, I decided just to stack them. I think CPDC will be comfortable With this proposal, I've just done on two other projects in town, and as long as they're designated as employee spaces, they're happy about it. And as we talk, I still have 38 parking spaces total. As long as you have additional parking, as we talked about, the town use for a school project is 21 parking spaces. If we were at 17 and I was trying to create an additional four this way, they'd have a problem with it, but we're above what the town deems the minimum parking requirement at 21. I think they'll be okay with it. But that will be for CPDC to review and approve. And I did have email correspondence with the fire chief. He is acceptable to the 20-foot driveway width. It still requires CPDC approval, and the reason I called him is I know at the last meeting someone mentioned in another site on Main Street that he had approved like 18 feet or 20 feet, but I wasn't sure if that was for one-way traffic or two-way. And in our site, it's two-way traffic, so I thought to be safe, I'd give him a call. I forwarded him a copy of this plan, and he emailed me back, and Gene Delios, who's the town planner, saying he found this plan to be acceptable. And so when we go to CPDC, I would assume that email would go to CPDC with this plan. So I think we tried to make every, just to add on to what Ken said as well, these are the no parking signs. There's one, two, three, four along the drive. Like Ken said, we're willing to eliminate them or reduce the number if CPDC allows us to do that and the police chief. It was the police chief who specifically asked for those to be placed at a DRT meeting before we even went to our first CPDC hearing. So at this point, I left them in. I think that really will depend on CPDC.
We have, because of the shortage of time, we didn't get to FedEx you the seven hard copies, but we have three. Just make sure these are the right ones. I'm sure they are. So we're going to give you the three that we have in case you want to use them as exhibits to a decision.
Anything else, Sam?
Okay. Yeah. Thank you.
Okay.
These are reduced size that way. I can get full size copies as well. Did one change ever, just to have a... On our previous plan, we had the two handicapped spaces, and one has to be a van accessible space. And in talking with Mr. Bolton, he wanted two additional handicapped spaces. So on my previous plan, I had 36 traditional parking spaces and two handicapped. Now we have 34 traditional parking spaces and four handicapped. He thought it was important that he's only required to have two, but for this, for his use, he wanted two additional. It we needed four, but just to be upfront on that.
I'm sorry. Commission, have any questions? Thank you.
That is the slides.
That is our presentation.
I want you guys to squeeze back here. I just want to talk to the commission for a second because we were trying to figure out what we were doing last time. Do you have a preference on what you take first? Do you want to talk about this parking situation first? Do you want to talk about the appropriate, non-applicability or the appropriateness certificate things, the few things, and it is a relatively few things that we have in there, or what? Any preference?
Yeah, that'd be a good one. Just out of bed.
Let's start with the appropriate one. So, okay. Anybody else have any feeling about that? That in mind, these are the original six that were sent in the August 2018 by Mr. Mike Olin's office. The original six. Request for the certificates of appropriateness. I got to keep that. Mm-hmm. So that's the easy part. What I've done is I've tried to go through and gone through and trying to figure out what was missing, what do we need to have for what spots. And maybe we have some answers now that we can fill in some of these blanks and get your questions answered. Again, these are the ones that are the questions that you might want to be looking at. And I think we've got some of those answers already. With this in mind, we're looking at the certificate of appropriateness, trying to connect up those few loopholes that we have and make sure we're all set. On the east facade of the non-historic shed, the non-historic barn shed, first floor, left side, we installed a new door. That's the one they showed in the slide, wood. And we have no problems on the design. It's just going to be a match.
Well, I appreciate the match, but I assume the architect has checked to see if the glass is appropriate for the student population and all, and it meets all the requirements.
Yeah, there won't be any problem.
Okay.
And that's a custom manufactured door, and it will be done by, you know, manufactured by any requirement.
Do any of the doors have to have push bars or anything? So we wouldn't. I just didn't. Okay. Thank you.
So this door is matching the two that are on the south side of the building now.
Okay.
If I'm correct, right? So they're. Those wood are metal, we know.
Metal.
Yeah, metal. And to match. Are we all set on that? Okay. To install a new retaining wall with newer grading at the east facade of the non-historic addition shed to block the visibility of the four new HVAC units. Is there any problem with that? Ginny, you're going to set up with the computer. Yeah, well, I think we're probably going to need that eventually.
Okay, look at this.
Under the HVAC area, that area, and this is just a concern, I don't know where it falls, where it doesn't fall. That area, which is going to have a retaining wall in it, and basically the retaining wall comes up close to where that door is. I'm just going to set up a slide.
Leave it for a sec. I can show you again the image if you so want.
This area right in here is actually a retaining wall right in here. It's going to block the view of that.
Yeah, but it's going to be sloped.
The ground is going to be sloped up to it.
Slope, so it won't
be. I guess my concern is not knowing the width right here of the sidewalk and the fact that this is going to be a drop off into that space. I don't know what to call it. Where the four HVAC, HVAC are. I was concerned with the fact that there might be one here, some sort of a railing system on here.
These are very schematics because even the size of those units, it's approximate, you know, we don't know. And as such, dimensions will vary there. It will be made safe from the entrance pathway to the door.
Well, I guess the problem I'm having is that if a rail system is needed here, because this has now become the main entrance, and people will be coming up the sidewalk, coming to here, and I don't know, a foot and a half, 6 inches away, there's going to be a potentially a three and a half, 4 foot drop off. The problem is, if you want to put that in, that becomes a required for a certificate of appropriateness.
We can have that, we can have that covered by plants in front of it.
Or you could stipulate what you'd like there right now, which would be fine.
So you just don't have to come
out. I think you're absolutely right, and I'm very pleased that you picked up a potential safety concern. Thank you very much.
So if
you would like to stipulate, you'd like a wood handling, whichever you would like, we would be happy to put it.
Well, I just want to eliminate.
Fair point. It's absolutely fair.
There obviously is, I don't know whether it would be affected by coming this way or not, but if you need to do 3 feet out and 2 feet along, something so that there's an elevator that protects some kid from stepping off. Or
absolutely.
I don't know where the doors, which way the door is going to be opening. I assume that the door handle would be on this side, would open to it, so that it would block it would be better.
But you're right, you would still have a railing.
So I guess I would request that the railing be either wrought iron metal, more
very,
secure.
Very appropriate wrought iron metal. Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, is that all right with the board? Okay. So I guess that falls, I don't know if that's down under my new things or not. I'm just working it. It's a really trying to spend some time to work with it. Okay? And I'm asking this only because it's a thought. In the process of grading up to here with this walkway coming on it, right currently now, there is a small retaining wall in here of natural stone.
Yep.
I don't know if the board has any feeling about it, but then I can see it move someplace else. I just have no feeling about it at all. But it is a lost feature on the ground.
So will that exist though? Because isn't that what
it won't exist. It won't exist. Right. The tunnel will eliminate it. It's a lost wall. Okay. And my general concern, I have a hard time visualizing this coming down. Sloping at you, this area here sloping at you, not washing into this, sidewalk coming along here, and tipping. I have a tough time seeing all the grades in my head change.
We could, the retaining wall to block the HVAC units could be a stone wall, and we could try to reuse some of the stones.
I have,
if that's, we don't have a problem if it's a stone wall.
Would you want that? It'll be
rubble stone. I mean, it's not artificial stone.
I can probably catch it in one of the pictures. Thought the board might be interested in the rubble stone being used. Or showing out at the end or something, out in here or something, because it's a warm feature.
Absolutely.
Okay. Okay, other questions going down through. Jenny, I think I need that.
Picture?
Yeah. We're going to be requesting a multi-port system down there. I think that's the same.
That's my
a little fuzzy.
Yeah, I was not.
I don't know why either. I could have stayed with Mickey's. Well, anyway, the retaining wall that's right here, I have a hard time telling whether it's the retaining wall actually for this or the retaining wall possibly because of the edge of the tunnel. The grading in there would be quite sensitive to that, and I don't want it to wash into your HVAC. So that's something you might want to watch out for. I guess enough with that. That covers the house in terms of certificate of appropriateness as far as I'm concerned. I don't disagree with anything that's on the sheet. The commission have anything that's on the house. I guess my question in here, and I'll see if I can do it. The opening that's here, now in the foundation, is relatively large. That portrait there looks to be about, I don't know, let's say 15 feet, 12 feet, 15 feet. The tunnel's going to be occupying part of it. So I'm assuming it's going to be half, part of this foundation wall is going to have to be filled.
It's probably going to be the other side, isn't it?
No, the tunnel is here.
Oh, that's the non-historic condition.
That's the non-historic. I can.
Yeah, I get it. No, you're right.
It's a relatively large opening because from here to about here. And so I assume that you're going to have some foundation wall in there. Not knowing how big and whether the tunnel has like a casement around it or anything like that.
Correct me if I'm wrong, but when we go in the floor and we have to do segmented replaced foundation wall.
Sure. That would be
it'll be keyed into that,
right.
I'm sure.
I just would like to make sure that the improvement is part of the appropriateness because it's filling a hole.
Mm-hmm.
It's
mm-hmm.
Okay? Yeah, I think I can find out. I'm all set with the building now. Okay?
The house.
Okay. The historic house and the non-historic condition.
Mm-hmm.
So, I do have quite a few concerns on the barn, and let's see if I can get myself organized enough to deal with it. On the east side of the facade of the basement level, the new egress door of raw material, the one that's going on the barn is going to look like the one that's the wood one. Okay. You all set on that, folks?
The one that's on the south side of the barn will be replicated on the east side of the barn.
The one that's on the, yes, yes. The one that's on the south side will be replicated.
They all look similar to that one.
Let's see.
The one that's down there, will. The one that's on the house will look like the ones on the south side of the house.
Right. There's another one.
There's
some white ones.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. There are two windows, I think that's been answered, that they will replicate the ones in the attic on the house, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So that's all taken care of. Do we have a picture of the east facade on the barn? Yeah, the window. Sorry. I'll make sure. This has to be filled. There is going down here. And this is the approximate ground level right now. So I guess my question is what's behind the top and sheet? Is that wood?
Yeah.
Or is that going to be filled?
Yeah, we'll go down with wood.
Okay, that's where, is this going to be filled with wood then?
Yeah.
Okay, then I need, because we can't see through the top.
It'll come down the clapboard bed. Yeah,
that hole is going to be filled with wood, and I assume clapboard like the rest of the block.
Exactly.
Okay, so we need to make sure that that's specified in there at some particular point. Okay? Bear with me for a second. I think this is a new architectural feature, this set of stairs. I have some concerns about it, and I'm going to upset us about it, because this is going to be some sort of a retaining wall. This is going to be graded down in front of it. And there's a walkway right here. I believe there's a walkway right there. So I'm not sure how much of this will be below grade, or whether this... this is a feature that appears here because I think of it, some of it's going to be above grade. Okay? And again, I don't have a problem with it. I just want to make sure we get it in there so we take care of it. I believe there's a walkway right in here also.
Yes.
So I was wondering, since it's a full set of stairs, I assume it's going to be concrete?
Concrete. Okay. Nikki, I don't know. My walkway is concrete.
I suppose concrete, yes.
Okay. So those stairs will be concrete as a new feature.
Right.
They're going to be a full length. Again, I think since there's a walkway right here, there might be a one for a gate or some sort of a railing right there, or or something?
Yeah, we'll have period railing, just as we'll have them.
Okay.
Exactly.
That's in the same spot.
Exactly.
Okay. And again, I don't know how this is going to work, because this has to be graded this way, and this is well below grade, I think, at this point. I just can't visualize those rail line.
There'll be a wall there, right?
Yeah, of course.
There'll be a wall here.
But, and also one.
And this way.
Coming out this way.
Right, yeah.
If you have the plan, you showed the plan at some point, it will tell me.
That other one you had up my chart.
Yeah.
Down there.
There.
So this is all gonna be encased here?
Yeah.
That's all retaining wall, okay, fine. Once I see it, so the grading will go down from here, but this will already be low, so it'll just go lower from here, okay? Again, there's a walkway into here, I wouldn't want a kid to go down those, okay? Number eight, the horse light has been explained, gonna be a plain piece of glass, or double pane piece of glass. Number nine, on the west facade, the left barn door will be changed from sliding to hinged. We need that only to make sure it retains to look the same. I don't think that's a problem. On the east side, foundation wall, I think I've talked about that now. I think I'm all set. I would ask if the board has any questions about anything on the certificate of appropriateness material.
I'm going to add a question. The stairs, that long flight of stairs, how many stairs are there, and is there a building code provision that would affect, that would require you to have one of them?
I don't know.
That's not a question for you, that's a question again.
I know, that's why I ducked it.
12 feet.
Did you hear that? No, I didn't hear.
So the question is, that flight of stairs that goes down,
yeah.
How many stairs are there?
That,
and is there a building code?
How many steps?
Yes.
I remember nine, but I might be wrong.
Show the back one again. No, not that one.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, that one. That doesn't look like
that. That looks like a lot more than nine.
Yeah, okay, well.
And
yeah, so?
And the question is there a building code requirement that you have a landing?
Yeah, we'll have, you are absolutely right. It was sketched up like this as a, as a way of showing that you go down the stairs. You're absolutely right, Attorney Meares. There will have to be a landing in the middle.
In the middle.
Okay, and once you comply with that, you have enough room?
I'm sorry?
Once you comply with the requirement of having a landing, do you have enough room?
We'll make
get
it,
down.
Yeah, well, maybe what we don't know exactly at this point is how many feet we will lower the dirt floor of the basement. We don't know. I mean, this will come with a design. So it depends if we lower it 2 feet only or 2 feet six, makes a difference, or 3 feet. We don't know at this time.
But you can slide the door.
I'm sorry?
So you can slide the door to the right. If you need a line,
yeah.
If you need a line run under the stair, you
the whole,
can
whole area is open.
Yeah.
From corner to corner right now, it's open.
And I guess this is that corner that I was questioning before about actually seeing the wall of the tunnel. And this wall here and this wall here appear not to be at the same level. So if you grade away from this, it's going to be hard to come up in midair to grade away from that.
We would put this in the book. Rumblestone and the narrow off of the corner down, preserve that and replace that foot. And for that connector, I want to know if we create a swale.
So to move water away.
Yeah, keep the water away
and
maybe keep some snow away or whatever.
Right.
And leave yourself some working in there, because I think that's going to be your work area.
And preserve a pastoral view.
Other questions on the floor line?
Was there a railing on all of these stairs or so?
Well,
a railing, you say?
There will be a railing.
There has to be a railing. Yeah.
Anything that's above grade would probably have to have a railing. And again, if it's stipulated.
Yeah, I would just say any railings you could put in a stipulation, any railings will be wrought iron, period, appropriate.
Yeah. Is that okay? Everybody else settled on that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. It's just an open set of stairs, and I'm just a little concerned about it. Okay.
What's the purpose of those stairs?
To get down to the, all right, get down to that back door. I assume it's a requirement for
it
exit.
It's the second means of egress from this level, mandated by code.
You're in the cell, well, you're
so
in the basement.
There's one exit here, and the other one is there.
Second level.
So from the lowered floor in the basement, you'll be exiting out, and the egress will be up a flight of stairs.
Correct. Mm-hmm. I don't want criteria to feel that we're trying to put them through the ringers or anything like that. We did 45 minutes on a pair of garage doors the other day. Yeah, just one pair of garage doors, because it's just very difficult. We used to deal with much smaller things, and this is all coming at us.
I'll stay all night if we're not talking about our right to exist. You know, if we're talking about the quality of construction and appearance, I have no problem. We want a beautiful, period appropriate preservation.
Okay, thank you. Any other questions from the board on certificate of appropriateness?
Well, I'm not sure how we're dealing with this.
Well, we're trying to get down the three criteria. What object, where is it located, and what's it made of? And, well, in design. And so I think most of them have been covered now. It's very difficult to look through this and make sure that we have them all up. I tried to go down through them, and we hit them.
But are these going to be all conditions within a certificate?
Yes. Just like we put up the garage doors and said, okay, are we going to accept them as metal? Yes, because it's a natural material. Okay. You know, we don't care about the color, but we do care about the trim that goes around and stuff like that. So all those are conditions that we talk about. Each one of these has some conditions with it. Some are, for example, the storm windows are not in our jurisdiction. But if you're going to work on them, we have the right to know. We can't control what you put on.
And that's exactly why I pointed out that we go, because we believe that restoring the storm window, keeping them and restoring the ones that are in the interest of the history of the house.
Well, okay. And I'll offer it up right now, because if you run out of the little brackets that hung the windows, I got a jar of them in my house.
Oh, yeah.
And I've removed enough storm windows so that I don't have to do that. Okay? Any other questions? Okay.
Well, I guess I would like to revisit the metal door, if they're going to, in the existing house. It might be worthwhile to start replacing with wooden doors so that when they come about.
I share your concern. You know, maybe one happy to take and replicate the doors and replace them with metal doors if we have.
And they'd be custom made wood doors.
That would be all three, is that what you're saying?
Yeah, I mean,
correct.
We're not going to do that below here. We're going to do it right. I agree with that.
I guess my question is, I don't know what's on the front door of the house, but the original door is out in the barn.
Yeah.
One of those, the natural wood door out of the barn, I heard the other night was half of the front doors. I don't have any particular design flavors, but maybe somebody
does.
The
very front door now that faces the driveway is an oak door. It was put in 1909. That's when the front of the house changed.
I guess that would be appropriate. You know, one that's not seeing a picture of that one. So.
It would be a shame not to replace those metal doors.
You're putting in one, and then you have one made, you might as well, in my opinion, do it. Okay.
Yep.
So then, again, that's a certificate of appropriateness for three doors now. So
assuming, again, that preserving our rights, just so you want to prove it.
I made that. We're not withdrawing the original proposal, but yes, the answer is yes. Three wood, custom made wood tools.
Do Other questions? On the house or on the barn, the certificate of appropriate.
These items are primarily so that they won't have to come before us again, should the certificate of appropriateness be granted tonight. However, if the plans change, they will be obliged to come before
us. That says it right on the certificate, that if the plan changes or we run into problems, you have to just come down and deal with it. I guess we'd be able to get with this right, because it's not just an application, it's a huge application, which is for the non-applicable, and for the appropriateness, and for all that comes along with it. Okay.
I think the only potential problems I could foresee would be if for some reason the CPDC gets sticky in any of these elements. I don't think I don't think there'd be any design issues, but we know we have to come back with this change.
Right. And I guess what I'm offering is the Historic District Commission will probably be there on the CPD next night so that we can encourage what we think is appropriate.
Yeah, we'd love to not have a problem.
Is that all right? If some people want to show up and deal with that, and well, three or more of you gather in his name, we'll post the meeting.
Specifically, it probably makes sense for you to notice that notice a hearing of this commission to occur simultaneously.
I'll post it for the same time.
Well, we'll have to notice it as a hearing. Not just post it, but notice it as a hearing on not a continuance of this hearing, a new hearing to consider any changes, so that if the CPDC makes a change or wants to make a change, you can rule on it right then.
Yeah. It would have to be a quorum of that to work.
That's right. That's right. It would be a full meeting, but it would just be both the CPDC and the HDC would be holding a hearing simultaneously in the same room, hearing the same
application. I think it makes great sense. And if there are no changes, CPD says, we give you this blessing, then
there's no need for the HDC to do anything either.
Okay.
Makes sense to me.
This is, I think we talked about the appropriateness. Now let's talk about the non-applicability.
We want to start off. Do we want to vote on these as we go along, or do we want to once again? Do we want to vote on these as we go along, or do we want to wait and do it all as a package at the end? What would my colleagues feel is less confusing? I would opt for as we go along, but just because we can get a sense of closure as we move through all
right.
This.
Okay. Do you want to put a motion on the floor for the certificate of appropriateness on these items?
The existing house?
The existing house and barn.
I'll make a motion then for the certificate of appropriateness for the existing house and barn.
And the non-historic structure. Addition. Do we have a second?
I think you need a
What is the motion? Motion to approve it?
Yes.
To approve the appropriateness on the things that we've talked about and are on the list for the existing house, the non-historic addition, and the barn.
I'm confused then.
It's a purview of the parking area construction.
We're
going to
need
separate. We're just trying to get pieces done.
Things that we agree on moving forward.
Okay. Do we have a second?
I second.
We all said, Jim?
No, I want some discussion.
Okay.
Well, then there'll be discussion after the second.
What about the guidelines and our recommendations and wood and this and that? Somebody.
Eric has been taking copious notes.
I think they're all covered. I think they're all covered in their original presentation to us, or location is some sort of a problem, but we've talked about each one of them where they are. So they just have to say where they are. Somebody's, Eric's doing a great job here.
Okay.
The video camera's doing a great job. And then what's the design and material they're made of? I think we're all set on all of them. Bite my tongue if I didn't. I think criteria perfectly, and I know I intend that we've got those pretty much under control. The question was, door lightness. I guess the only one I question, and it was brought up at the pre-hearing we had about this, was the two or three windows on the south facade that are in the upstairs of the addition, the non-historic addition. Those will look very 70s up there.
They are on both sides, north and south.
Oh, see, I don't know about the other side. But if they're not proposing to change them, we can't ask them to change them. But I'm just saying that.
Can I say the same?
I know what I would like to do. But you understand my reluctance.
It's just a case of if you want to put them into the application, we'll do it. If you don't, come again.
What I would like to do is make them very appropriate. But I hesitate to raise that, fear it might cause a delay or some other time. That's my honest reservation.
So we're willing to make those windows period appropriate, but Dr. Littleton said he doesn't want to delay anything with that offer. But if that's something that you think would look better, so does Dr. Littleton.
I'm not getting why it would cause a delay.
I don't think it would.
Incorporated.
No, I understand that. I understand that. I'm just expressing my client's concern. So, Mr. Blodgett, if you all think that those 70s-looking windows would look better being period appropriate, we are offering to do that.
But they are in the annex. They are, the annex does not have the historic elements that the house has. What we can do is to modify those north and south to jibe more with the rest of the annex.
Maybe make somebody feel better. How old is the non-historic? Do you know that?
I don't know the exact date, but I do know that those windows were put in right after I bought the house, like 31 years ago.
Okay, so they are truly non-historic, right? Because we use 70 years as the cutoff point. And actually, that becomes a it gets into confusion. So I have no problem changing or not.
You'd have to give us some discretion there, though. I guess what Dr. Littleton is saying is, since we don't have examples
right,
tonight, we don't want to have you say, you know something, we prefer the existing non-historic windows. So either you're going to give us some discretion, or just leave them as they are.
Why don't we just leave them as they are?
You can always put them later.
It's easiest to leave them as they are.
Let's just leave them as they are, because there's no way that is ever going to look like the main house. Mm-hmm.
Right. Okay. That's fine. Yeah.
Okay.
I have a question.
Yeah, a question.
On procedure. I'm not clear how we're doing this. I'm sorry, I'm dense, but are we now making a motion for issuance of a certificate of appropriateness?
Yeah, for the house.
I think
for
the house, the motion is to incorporate approval of these elements into the certificate of appropriateness when you issue the certificate of appropriateness.
All right.
So in other words, you're not prejudging that there will be a certificate of appropriateness overall. If there is one, these things will be approved in it.
Okay. And then that motion will be more specific as to 7.3.76.
Well, I don't know who's going to write it.
No, I mean, it's a simple motion, I think, once we get to the point of having a certificate of appropriateness.
We put all the pieces in.
Yeah.
Right? Is that what we're doing?
Right. So once you've gone through your deliberations on all that stuff, we are prepared to pass out a first draft that obviously does not incorporate any of the stuff you've been talking about now, but it gives you an idea of what the overall decision would look like. You can talk about that. Next, or next time, depending on the time after passing that.
So we have a motion on the floor, seconded. We talked about it. It's just to do the piece of appropriateness for the house and the non-historic addition and the barn.
Understood.
Okay. Yeah. Any other further discussion? All those in favor? 5-0. All opposed, 0. We got something done. It's a feel good. This is the attachment A that you gave us,
yes.
Which is literally the non-applicability listing. Those things which do not. Again, you have to notify us where it is, what it's going to be done with, and what it its design. But we just then approve it, or as it would be.
We notify it before this work before work begins.
Right. Well, basically, this is it. If everything goes through. Didn't really talk. Each window was brought up separately. So this is the windows which are going to be remediated. Okay. Otherwise, all the other windows, which are not going to be remediated, are going to be on the other list as replacements. Okay.
Are they all going to be remediated?
No, all windows in the two buildings are not going to be remediated. If some are basically plywood or like the horse-like windows, we have said that they're going to put period to this or light this or whatever the case might be. Those are not remediated. Those are new windows.
Okay. So they're in the certificate.
So they're in the certificate.
Okay. The work is now work that is to which
misunderstood remediated.
Replacing lichen.
So this means that they will do the lead removal. They will reglaze with non-asbestos glaze. Okay. They will repaint as they are. Okay. Again, we don't have jurisdiction over the storm windows, but they've informed us that the storm windows are going to be done. Mm-hmm. So that's basically would be in here. Okay?
Now who's going to add that to this list?
Somebody has to add this to this list. Mm-hmm. Storm windows. Add it. Okay?
Perhaps a young associate.
number 8 on the house. Now, sure, I'm on the right listing here.
Porch roof?
The attachment A.
Porch roof?
Porch roof.
Porch roof. I need a clarification. Reflash existing edges with aluminum and repair or replace single ply member roofing with EDPM to match existing roof top of brick. Don't care about the color. I want to know is the roof's coming down here, is this aluminum under here, or is it on the fascia of the roof?
The edges of the edges, I would have to look at myself, Mr.
You understand my question? The fascia is the front with in the back of the gutter, okay? I would question what's there now, and is that what's aluminum? Are you replacing aluminum with aluminum?
No. I think this pertains to the flashing against the wall.
Oh, never even thought of it. Edges, the back edges, not the front edge. Okay, so you're talking about that. Okay, I don't have any problem with that.
The aluminum, is that ever a dark color?
Yeah.
Will it be? I mean, we don't have jurisdiction over color, but it would certainly be. You don't want
aluminum
silver
anodized.
Yeah.
Well, most of it's underneath the cloud or underneath the membrane. I was concerned about the fascia being wood down and making it aluminum. I didn't know what you meant by edge, so.
No, it's the other edge on the, in the back.
Okay. The building flashing, actually. It's not the roof edge. We understood on that one. That also occurs on the barn, by the way, that same comment. I don't know why that happens on the barn, but.
Probably happens where the dormer comes up.
Right, but I don't know what's going on against the other.
It'd be a cricket on either side of the room, so we flash.
And on the number 10, we have a correction. Granite clapboard would become granite block. I guess that's a question I have in here all along. What kind of foundation is on which buildings? What kind of foundation does the original building have? What materials it made up? What kind of foundation does the non-historic addition have? And what kind of foundation work is in the barn?
It's just going to be matched to what's.
I know it's just going to be matched to what's there, but when I was seeing one of the slides for the first time, I saw a brick facade.
They are
rubble stone
blocks. Stone.
Field stone? It's a combination of large granite block.
Which is probably the absurd.
And some stone.
I noticed on the barn, I saw a brick facade.
Yeah, but that's on the, it's in the, on the outside of the foundation.
Right. But that's what we're talking about when it looks like, is what's there now.
We can see.
Okay. Number 3, I'm all set on the house now. Does anybody have any questions on anything non-historic, non-applicable for the house? And again, this is the list of 1 through 11 that they've given to us, and those are the 2 or 3 changes that I had, or questions I had. Are you following this? Nice job.
Don't tell us that.
Well, we'll see next week when Randy meet whether he did it right or not.
Is everybody all set on the historic, that existing house? Okay, and under the barn, again under Appendix A, it says existing barn, number 3. And I think I've had it answered to some extent. That fabricated and installed new barn door and trim on the rear, we talked about that already. That's been covered. That's going to have to move to appropriateness if it's new barn door.
Yes.
Okay. And we talked about what was going to be made of, so I'm all set on that. Number 4, we know where that barn door is located. It's on the south side finish, natural finish wood door that's on the south side. Okay. Number 6, wood window sashes will be remediated. Again, this falls under that whole question of remediation. If they're staying there, they're remediated. If they're not, they have a certificate of appropriateness to match something. I have 1 question there. On the north side of the barn, and I don't know if we can get a picture of it. How good is it?
There are 5 windows there.
There are 5 windows there. 2 are like, one is the top, one's on the first floor. And there are 5. There are 3 other things that are filled. What's happening with those filled ones?
I don't know what you're talking about. Out from the outside, there are 5 windows, I think, that are visible.
There are 3 windows that are visible and, 2 windows that are visible and 3 fillings. They look like they're the window frame with clapboard right now. It's on the north side of the barn.
North elevation, okay. The two windows and three openings that are boarded.
Yes, they're boarded. Three openings that are boarded. I'm asking what's happening with those three windows. I think the other two have glass in them, they have a window, so they're being remediated.
Let's see if we can find a photo of the house. Either you have or I'll try to.
Everett, was that the 06?
Does the diagram, which one?
This is the.
About the third one?
You have it.
Yeah.
There they are. It's on O2, A02. It's these three buildings right here.
No, these are not, I mean, these are visible windows. We have photos.
Well, why don't you put the photos in?
Yeah, let's see if we can.
Two windows look like windows. Now, in addition to that, in the front of the barn, in that deep section, is that a door or a window?
That's a window. It's where they actually could be in the hay.
And then there are two like eyebrow windows. Okay. I assume those are all being remediated. The windows would be remediated, but we just need to put them on the list. That's the problem. See, I don't know how this affects the interior of the building. That's something you're not going to consider or not consider.
I think it is right.
They just look different in the picture.
Well, I don't have here.
See, there's one of them right,
yeah,
right
that,
here.
Yeah,
that's
that one
of them right
is,
here.
That one is duplicated on the right, and they are open. They are framed windows.
There's glass in them?
I don't know. I can't remember if there's that, but there used to be.
There used to be a window.
Yeah.
I don't know if there still is, but I think we want to put on the list what's happening to those three things.
Fair enough. We're gonna put glass in them if they are blocked. I don't remember if they are, as you say, blocked in some fashion.
You would maintain the exterior appearance of the frame.
The exterior appearance will be maintained.
Which is the key.
So they would go on, these three would go on a certificate of appropriateness to be replaced with new windows. Thank you. Okay. You're adding window. If it's plywooded or boarded up, then you're going to take that out, you're going to put in a window with glass and wood in it.
Well, I think he's saying is that the frame of the window is there, just that glass is not.
Insert it instead of plywood.
Those two windows at the bottom, because we will have a stair behind them, they need to be made false windows.
Yeah.
But the framing remains, the outside frame.
Yeah, right? I understand that. So it'll look like where a window was boarded. Is that all three of them?
Yeah.
It's as it appears there.
Okay, that's what I guess we need to know. So it's being deleted.
We have painted. A choice. We have a choice of either making faux windows that are opaque and actually have a wall behind them, but to the outside match the appearance of existing, or blocking them. And I would say that would be up to the commission.
Yeah. Well, it's those three windows that I'm concerned about because I didn't have them any place.
Fair point.
What do you want to do?
I think it's going to take more study on their part because these windows.
No, it won't take any more study. We know that they're on the stair tread going up that wall. That's why they're shown that way as blocked out. We have those two choices, either to clapboard them, three choices. Clapboard where the window would have been, leave the window outline as exists, clapboard over the whole thing, or put a replica faux window in the back that turns the wall. Any of those three options would be fine with us. We just need to know.
I think that if, original appearance if we put put four windows.
But you know, there may be an occasion where you want the window to be a rear window. The way you show it on your plan, it's a light coming into the stair landing.
No, what's most important for us is that we move on. We have no problem with it. They're in a stairwell to begin with. They are not part of the ambient light plan in the classrooms or in any work area. This is really only about the exterior of the store appearance.
Say your preference.
In historic preservation, I think it's all right to leave the windows boarded up and clapped over, because that shows what was there previously and you're not recreating an earlier situation.
Okay, what I think she's saying is don't remove the trim.
Yeah.
Don't just come over
the way it appears here.
The way it appears, that's fine. Is that all right?
The frame.
Yeah.
And then the inside the frame is clapboarded.
And we will repair, restore, strip that those frames in place.
You mean the trim?
Yes.
Is that all right?
Yes.
Everybody will know there's a window there. It's adapting for the use of the building, and I have no problem with all of that. It's better to leave that trim there than to take it off.
I understand, exactly. Right?
Yes. And it would not burden you with having to make a phone now.
Who's on you?
Whose side am I on?
No.
Side by.
I'm in the middle, believe me. People don't think so, but I am. So the situation is board and paint is appropriate, I think. Okay, so it would fall into non-applicability. Okay? Anybody else have on that? I think that's all the questions I have on the non-applicability attachment A at the board. The commission, if they have other questions, I'd like that. See that? See that?
Number seven, we don't have input over gutters and downspouts, but I think it's great that they included it in there.
Right, again, that's... we don't have, just because we don't have jurisdiction, means they still have to notify us
that
that it's a certificate, it goes under the certificate of non-applicability.
I don't think we'd like to know this. Okay.
Stamp on that. Okay. Other questions off the commission?
Should we have a motion that this attachment A be included in any certificate of non-applicability that we might issue?
Well, all these things will be in it, plus the changes that we've...
Okay, well, would you like a vote on it?
Yeah, if we finish talking about it a little bit here. Okay. Give me a time to wheels to turn, mine are slow. Okay. Any other comments or questions about the non-applicability section? So this will be a piece like we did with the appropriateness. It would be just a piece that we will put a motion on the floor, get a second, and any discussion about it, and then we'll move on to parking.
I make a motion that attachment A be included as part of any future certificate of applicability.
Non-applicability.
With the corrections as noted.
With the corrections as noted.
Okay. Second on that? Priscilla?
I second it.
Okay. Any other discussion about that? I think I've got everything covered. We should. And Eric's doing a great job. Seeing no further discussion, all those in favor of the attachment A and noted corrections on that would be fall under the certificate of non-applicability. All those in favor? All those opposed? 5-0. ready, yes, we can be ready. I'm sorry I'm moving still. I'm just moving.
Too many pieces.
Yeah.
The topic area now that we'll take into this consideration is the driveway parking. We're put under one jurisdiction. So I would like to see if we have discussion about that. Yes.
For point of reference, does anybody have this little set of plans?
No, we have three copies. They're right there. One, two, three.
Because this is, in fact, a summary of all the discussions. These drawings.
That's correct. Just the only reason we didn't get them to you and have the larger size is just we were doing an awful lot of work in a very short period of time. We just barely got it.
I noticed the sheets of paper are getting smaller and smaller. Next meeting, they'll be like this.
The first one's away. So again, I'm going to open it for discussion about the parking situation and see if anybody has any questions, comments, if they'd like to do it.
We do have a full scale.
And this is the correct, what you're offering in right now, the corrected mode is 1, 2, 3, 4, with 1, 2, 3, 4 handicap, 1, 2, 3, 4 handicap. And the additional spots in the back.
One more set if it helps.
Virginia.
Well, just to start off, I think they did a superb job in reconfiguring all and meeting almost all of our concerns, primarily reducing the paved area that I reluctantly call a driveway from 24 to 20 feet is most appropriate and much better for the historic district. And I'm pleased with the overall attempt. I would think that our next challenge will be to convince other groups within the town to approve this as well, to be comfortable with it. Thank you.
Other questions, comments?
In my conversations offline with Mr. Margolin, he indicated he thought that the proposal would come back with a reduction in the overall number of parking spaces, so that it would show fewer than 38. And it didn't happen.
No.
And I just wonder if there's an explanation.
Yes, there is. When I mentioned that, Ray, I thought I said, and pretty sure we said publicly too, Bob would have to go back to what we always call as program people, the people actually running the program, and they said we really need the 38 that we vetted so thoroughly with the CPDC. You know, it's the floor is not going to make a big difference in appearance, so we'd ask that we not be squeezed to make this a long-term program.
I'd like to comment on that. I think it does make a big difference, moving them to the back, number one.
Oh, yes, of course.
Now, the green space distance from the road to the first paved parking area, it's almost exactly the same as the distance from the road to the first parking space in the existing driveway. So actually no closer to Summer Ave.
And there'll be more vegetation.
That's one point. The other is, you know, we tried not to put more paved surface in, so by putting the four at the back, with double restricted to employee parking, we didn't have to put a TN or put any type of, it would have been more paving still, to, if those weren't employee-only stand. So we think we met, we just really heard everybody about not wanting to end up with overflow in summer end. And I thought that that was critical. And so by double stacking, we thought it was a good compromise. It'll be low probability of use. And we didn't think would cause us so much inconvenience that we needed to create extra pavement to create that T. We would have had to take out two stalls, put them back, and put six behind there. They have 38, and we would have more paved surface. So we just thought it was a good compromise, getting them to the bag, but yeah, restricting them to employee parking.
All right. Another question. If at some time in the future the town expresses an interest in entering into an arrangement with you to utilize some of your parking spaces in support of the middle school that's directly behind, is there anything about this configuration that would be a barrier to that?
I'm going to start. You know, my concern is I have no idea about the sensitivities in the neighborhoods or otherwise on that issue.
Let me just finish.
I don't want to kind of step into a landmine I know nothing about. I will say this, if that were the town wishes and the townspeople agreed, and there were no controversy around that, that would in any way delay our application or conflict us in any sorts of way, as good partners with the community and as a major human service, existing major human service provider in this community today, we would be happy to do anything that knits us more closely into the fabric of education and human services in this town. And so okay, that's all okay. I can say.
Well, but I'm actually asking you a physical question.
You know what I'm saying? And you think, I think you get the answer, and I think, you know, with the linear lineup that's created there, it's probably no barrier to that. Let me just put it that way.
Okay, this is an endopic. I was hoping to hear an answer from the engineer.
Can this physically be done, a connection through? Sure.
Yeah. The question is, are you making it, is there anything about this design that would make it more difficult?
No.
Okay. That's all.
and we would not agree to make that as some kind of condition of this.
No.
But
nobody
said
has suggested
all along,
that. Nobody has suggested that. I just,
at some point,
I just don't,
they will have.
If we're inadvertently doing something here that will prevent that from ever happening in the future,
right,
we at least need to know that we're doing it.
I heard that, and Jack, you say no, that can be done, correct?
If, and we're not showing this, but I'd have to remove a couple spaces here, remove this, we put the connection through, and then we have parking this side and this side. It could be done.
Okay.
I know where that question came from, because I basically proposed it at some particular point along the way, because I know the traffic situation here. And at certain times, depending upon whether you're working or I'm going through or somebody else is going through, you don't get through. You know, you sit and wait for people to pick up that publish that, like I say, too many people drive, and it's a problem. And it gets to be the understood mode of transportation. So maybe even a one-way or something through there down the road. We don't think it can get through for now either. There's too many variables that have to be talked about. What I would like, if there's any other comments from the commission at this point, I'd like to talk a little bit, and this is my concern. I'm not saying it's not resolved, but this is my concern, that this is an historic building, but this is also a historic building. And there's a lot happening right in this area. And lower trees here, fine. I'm not so sure about higher trees here because it blocks the visibility of this. When we were having initial discussions, back under the other application, we talked about the fact that this would get blocked. I think people like to see that barn. So everybody, not everybody, a lot of people tend to think it's all about the building. It's all about the building. It isn't. It's about the site as a total. Because if you have a nice, beautiful building and you can't see it, it presents problems. I think this one is well taken care of, but I think this one is not well taken care of. I don't know how to solve the problem. I have drawn a proposal that would come up here and make a turn so that there would be less permanent parking here along the way, still allowing handicap to be up in here. Not accepted. Not totally sorry about that, because there was actually an increase in the amount of pavement that was going to be required.
That's, you might want to bring it up.
Well, I know that, but there's pros and cons. I have another concern that this coming up to here presents a lot of difficulty for your clientele to have to make a three-point turn up there. It's just tough. If they go in here, if they park here, they can turn and come back out. But if they go up here and they park, they probably can get around and come back. But if they decide to just go up and go around, I assume that might be still okay. I know these big guys with the fire engines can probably do it, but I just watch a lot of people driving. My reference point is Parker Tavern. Okay? They drive over the lawn. They just can't turn in that spot. And it's similar. This is a long driveway, this poor sight up the end. And they have no parked cars up in there, so there's going to be a, I contend this might be a problem for your clientele. I am not displeased with the moving back here. I'm still feeling tough about seeing this building, which is such a beautiful carriage house.
I think that's really for you folks to decide. We'd be happy with whatever you want us to do.
In terms of vegetation, we don't care about the size. That's really something we'll abide by.
The vegetation really isn't in this. I'm just expressing a personal perception. A lot of this is...
Well, to be honest, I mean, those were added at the request and the feedback you received here. So my only point is, whatever consensus is here, we'll be happy to do.
Well, down this side, I think, and these aren't too bad, but in here especially, no.
We're not proposing anything in there, Everett. No. There might be some ground cover.
I'm still looking at this for the first time. These are the three I was worried were over here, and they're not. Okay.
Okay. Those three. The only reason I put those in is to along the entrance to give it a tree line look. I have no problem if these three get removed, and these three arborvitae were just put in to screen any cars that parked in here, but if you feel they're not needed,
I thought those three were over here, and I was looking at a different plan.
I think, correct me if I'm wrong, wasn't that to respond to the feedback about the cathedral look?
Correct.
Those were put there specifically in response to feedback received at last meeting.
Yeah, but again, I'll specify, I thought they were over here, and they're not there next to the room. So there's still some visibility through here, and there's no parked cars down here, there's people walking and things, which is great. And we had that cathedral look down at the end of, well, where High Street goes into Washington. It's awesome. It's incredible. The board, the commission, so.
I think I would disagree with you on those trees. I think that they're far enough to the left so that one gets a view down.
I'll restate it again.
To the barn.
I thought those three were over in the lawn area.
Yeah, I did too, but they put them in, and so I'm saying let's take them.
Do you like where they are?
Yeah. I would keep them.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
And that's what I'm saying.
Oh, you are? Oh, I thought you were saying something different.
Those three trees were over here.
Oh, well, there's a line of trees down the right-hand side of the parking way, and then there are three trees on the left-hand side.
That's fine. But I thought they were further over here, and they were cathedral very nicely. I agree with it.
Oh, you agree? Okay.
Initially, I wasn't because I thought them in the wrong place. I had them in the wrong place.
So we are in agreement?
Yes.
Good.
I'm shorter. Any other comments from the commission on the parking?
I think just as as an aside, I would make the trees all the same species rather than having to mix and match. And your choice.
That's up to the commission. If you'd like to see all one style,
I mean,
one species, that's fine.
Not locusts.
No.
Not honey sucker locusts.
I would agree with Mr. Williams myself.
So what? Ginkgo's fine. If you like the ginkgo tree, we'll do the ginkgo tree.
Ginkgo biloba.
Any other questions from the commission?
No, the three honey locusts right on the street.
Oh.
And we won't do that again. But yeah, ginkgo biloba.
Other comments or questions from the commission?
Mr. Chairman, because there's been a new presentation tonight, would you care to open up the discussion to the public?
No. Yes, but you would too. Would the public like to have any input at the request of Mrs. Adams?
Hi, Mary Ellen O'Neill, 125 Summer Avenue. I would like to disagree with the tree issue, only because I understand in terms of appearance it would be nicer, but in terms of having it last, diversity is better, so that if anything attacks one of the trees, you're not going to lose all the trees. And you might have different growth rates and different lifespans so that you don't lose everything at once. You see certain sections of town where they did a big planting and then they all go in at once.
Yeah, there is a difference of philosophy here. It goes back all the way to the beginning of Western civilization. You can have ecological diversity or you can have architectural integrity.
I'll go for ecological diversity.
Yes, I am perfectly happy to go with whatever anybody wants.
And I just want to mention, I appreciate the idea of putting another tree in the tree lawn that has to be vetted with the tree warden and tree foreman.
Yeah, I think he'd be happy to have us provide that, but of course he'd have to approve the tree, the species of the tree. But I think that the town would be happy with any tree planted in the public way.
Well, they're having a big issue with the RMLD, so if the power lines are over there, you really do have to talk with them. They're having a big issue with that. About tree planting.
I just put it in as a bonus. If someone doesn't want it, we'll take it out.
No, I'm sure they like it. I'm just saying, talk with them and make sure at the type because of these issues going on in town.
I will. Thank you.
Other comments?
Hi, Ann Garvin, 189. Jack Sullivan, could you please speak to what the material for the porous pavement is going to be?
Yep, no problem. The porous pavement, it looks like traditional pavement. It's really the base material that separates it from traditional pavement. There'll be about 2 feet of crushed stone, and then the porous pavement's laid on top of the crushed stone. In the porous pavement, it's just larger diameter stone that has void space in it that allows water to move through it. But to most people, it would just look like your traditional driveway surface.
So as far as oil and other contaminants leaching into the ground, will that into the ground? And what about people that have wells within a certain amount of feet of that driveway that use it for their lawn?
I'm not sure. Oh, for irrigation purposes? Mm-hmm. That 2 foot layer of stone provides treatment. It traps material that moves through it. I don't, where they're not drinking water wells, if it's for irrigation, I don't know any of standards what distance we'd need to be away from a well. Do you know someone who has any
porous material?
Say that.
Are there any chemicals that can leach from that into the ground?
Antifreeze could go in, oil could go in. Sure. Yes.
So I think that's a concern.
Yep. Yeah, it's actually a method of stormwater control and that most towns like to see now. It's considered a low impact design. And I've used it on like 12 to 15 sites now, and it's actually one of the preferred methods.
And what was the long-term longevity of that? We talked about this in meetings past about the long-term
I'll get into it more at the CPDC meeting, but
okay.
There'll have to be an operation maintenance plan that Criterion agrees to. Every so often you have to vacuum clean the surface. The voids can fill over time with sand or debris, and it has to be vacuum cleaned so that this system remains efficient.
So then if there are any environmental concerns, then is that a CPDC issue? Or a town engineer issue? Or
yes.
Whose issue?
CPDC.
Okay.
Yeah.
We had provided a study that EPA did, and they said 80% of those porous pavement systems fail. And, you know, we provided that way back a couple of months ago when we were talking about this before. And that's when you changed from porous pavement to the traditional.
That wasn't the reason we changed.
Right.
Not because it was the town engineer. He didn't want to see the entire site porous pavement.
With a
mix.
Are very difficult to install, number one, and then there's a maintenance problem, and then they clog up, and then it fails.
The CPDC issue, and we're going to have to vet it before them when they get the expertise.
And UNH has a good porous pavement study. If you go on the UNH website, the engineering website, with studies, and I've used on, over the last 5 years, I've used on 12 different sites. I haven't had any issue.
We can't disrespectfully to everybody, including the audience. We can't resolve that tonight. It's a CPDC issue.
I do think it falls under the CPDC, and so you'll have to recognize that. Okay.
Mr. Lamb?
Jerry Lamb, 194 Summer. Jack, are you sure where the 4 feet was taken off from the plan?
Oh, the four parking spaces?
No.
The 4 feet? All the way in through here, Jerry. I took it off the. You live here.
Yeah.
It used to be wider here. I moved 4 feet away from your house.
All the way to the back.
All the way to the back.
So the curve is that reduced to the back room?
This point's the same, and then I widen out. There's a 24-foot travel aisle here. But this whole stretch here is 20 feet.
All the way back to where?
All the way back to here. Okay. Right to your back property line.
Jerry Lamb, 194 Summer Ave again. So why the choice of just four? Why not move more of the spots in front? I understand the handicap reason. You need those there. I thought that a lot of discussion last week was the handicap needed to be by the barn more, which I guess the back couple are close to the barn. But why stop at four? Why not put more back there?
Because we have casual use visitors in and out during the course of the day. We're not familiar with the property. Not going to be walking down to an employee parking lot and coming all the way back up to access the main entrance. That wouldn't be the normal traffic flow.
It's a low impact program, but it is an operational program. It has to serve the people that use it in a friendly way.
And there's only five traditional parking spaces in this stretch here, and then the four handicapped. So really, when you look at it, we have five traditional, we have six here. So there's 11 traditional spaces from here to here, and then the majority of the parking's in the rear.
And again, the first parking space is no closer to Summer Ave than the current bell or flange in the existing house.
Are there questions or comments from the audience or the commission? Oh, I've got one. I would like to say that I would like to see maybe a couple more move back, basically because we're still out beyond the real house, and it's good for people to walk. This is probably less than 200 feet. It's not a great distance. I'm sure the property's going to be well maintained, and the people will get a chance to see more of the facility. That's probably less than walking from CVS's back door across the parking lot when you had the park in the back. Yeah, it's not a huge distance. That's just my personal
opinion. We're talking about kids three and under, so what may not be a long distance to you, but you're a mother and you're having two kids, one that's a younger baby and a three-year-old, that's a long distance to walk.
Respectfully, Mr. Blodgett, this is, we're going to rest with this, this proposal.
I'm just putting my, what I feel out on. We that's just the way I feel about it. We need to have more people walking. If we have to, if we make it too convenient for them, guess what? They get in the car to drive around to the next driveway.
Right.
And it's just a hard place to be in. I recognize that.
What did you just say?
People get in their car because they don't know any different to get go next door.
To who's it? To someone else's home?
Yes. It's unbelievable.
You're suggesting that realistically.
I work.
The sign needs to be bigger.
So, Mr. Chairman, would we consider continuing this hearing until next week so that in the meantime we would have hard copies of our motions and decisions?
The two, one on the appropriateness and one on the certificate of non-applicability. And then confirming this, I would say we could probably do it either way. We could take it all in one vote at that particular point. I don't care how you decide you want to run it. I'm not going to choose that for you.
But I would say that since we last time we did a vote that we have jurisdiction over the site plan or the general appearance, et cetera, that we somehow incorporate this drawing, which is the 28th, it's the revision number 5, October 28th, site plan, as part of our deliberations and also part as part of a certificate. Mm-hmm. Is that?
Yes, I would agree with that.
And we could prevail upon the applicant to give us one that was a little bit larger.
Jack, get that done. Can you hand deliver them to the town hall?
Not tomorrow, it's closed on Friday.
Monday.
If they have delivered on Monday at a reasonable hour, I will deliver them out to the commission.
And there will be these, just bigger.
Mm-hmm. Now, there will be a number of things here that are contingent upon the CBDC. And who's the applicant is responsible for scheduling that meeting.
Well, we have to we have to contact CPDC, and
then let us.
Yes,
because we have to.
And I'll try to coordinate with Mr. Miaris on scheduling so that everybody, you know, we've been all good on scheduling issues.
Okay, because it would be important that we be there.
Yeah, any change.
Again, not just be there. I want you to have.
A quorum.
I want you to have a quorum. I want you to post it as a hearing of the commission so that you can decide, at least in theory, you can decide right on the spot whether you want to modify.
Yes, that's going to be an important meeting.
Just to agree with your comment, any change, we had a plan, a comprehensive plan, approved by the CPDC. So we will need their approval for any changes in that plan. We anticipate no difficulties, but I'm not predicting.
So that will go forward with CPDC and say, here is what the HDC has approved. Will you please approve it also? The CPDC says yes, then we're done. If they say, well, we're still not happy with the porous pavement or, you know, whatever, and they make some additional changes, rather than set these people up as in a game of ping pong where they now have to come back to us and we go back to them, if you hold the hearings, two simultaneous hearings, you can thrash it out right there, you can decide what you're going to do. CPDC can decide what they're going to do. And hopefully, both commissions will settle on something and approve the same thing.
That's theirs is
obviously the goal.
Theirs is a regular meeting.
Theirs will be a hearing. A public hearing.
Okay, then ours will have to be a public
hearing. And yours will be a public hearing as well. Yours will be a public hearing to consider any modifications to what you've already approved.
186, 190 Summer.
That's right.
And we'll have to have a timeline on that to make sure we're within the 15 days.
That's right. It's all tricky, but we can do it.
Okay.
But it's better to do it that way than to, have the applicant go to them and then come back to you, and then go back to them. That doesn't make sense.
Okay. I guess the question is, are we done now, tonight, or do you want to do something in addition to what's been done? Is there anything that we need to do and cover? I have one small thing to present, but it has nothing to do with criteria.
One thing I think we should do is we should distribute the draft of decision that we have been working on. Obviously, it incorporates nothing that we discussed tonight.
How are we going to get that?
Eric is going to do it.
Isn't this going to be completely redone after tonight?
Yes, this will be redone.
Well, yeah, not completely redone, hopefully we've got something.
How about just giving me the redone copy?
Well...
We need to be able to mark this up.
Are we supposed to mark this up, and we have another chance, is that what you're telling us?
You will have another chance, but if you, mark this up, yes?
Yeah.
Yes, those are public records, so...
Okay.
Do some of these incorporate materials that we sent to you?
Yes.
We tried to incorporate everything that we know. It's still, the document is growing.
I was going to say, it's going to be a encyclopedia. Do we have a timeline for...
So will you be able to email us the comments that came in today, so we can append them to this?
We can email you a new version that incorporates...
Oh.
We can do that.
Couple of hard copies.
Well, you're not even on our email list.
I know, that's why, I just want hard copy, forget it, I don't want any email.
Okay, well, somebody has to be responsible for getting them to you.
Yeah.
What do I have to do?
Jack isn't on the email distribution list, and he says he doesn't want to do it.
No, I'm just being facetious.
I'll take two and give him one. I'll make two and give him one. Is that all right? Anybody else that's that way? No, I usually go to one. I have to walk right by 186, 190 Summer Ave to do it.
To do it, okay.
Do we need a motion or anything at this point, Mr. Chairman?
Tell me.
You need a motion to continue the hearing to whatever the next day is.
We have, fourth, fifth have been posted. The fourth is a Wednesday, the fifth is a Thursday.
Wednesday would be very difficult for me, because you can do the fifth.
Problem with the fifth is the deadline for filing your decision is the sixth, and if you're going to make changes and what have you, it's hard to get it turned around.
If it's the fourth, I'll be here. It has to be the fourth, so be it.
Well, I mean, it's kind of up to you. You could also extend the deadline by a couple of days, and then we can accommodate you back. Okay, so the fourth it is.
The fourth it is.
Same time?
Yes. I believe it's scheduled for the selectmen's room at the town hall, 16 Wall Street, 7 o'clock.
Rather nomadic commission.
What's that?
We're nomadic, we move around.
Well, in Reading, it's very difficult. I hope people appreciate it. It's very difficult to find the right space and the right time and know what's happening. We got in here tonight, and the entire room is set up facing that way. So, changed. That's what you hired the chair for.
November 4th, 7 p.m. Town Hall.
November 4th, 7 p.m. Town Hall. I need a motion on the floor to extend the continuance.
I make a motion that we extend the hearing until November 4th.
Second?
I second.
Any discussion? All those in favor? Any opposed? 5-0. So I was passing these out. What are we doing? Are we making readings of this and correcting now? Or are we going to save that till next time?
No, I think that's for your reading pleasure.
This is
I'm a teacher. I don't do it.
Exactly. Yeah.
I hate to go a day without reading about it.
Question, when will the revisions be made and how will they be made available to the public before the 4th so that people have a chance to read through them?
Well, first of all, the new plan will be coming on Monday. And I assume it can be put online.
It will be the same plan that you have, just allowed.
Just Roger. So the driveway parking plan will be the same, it will be bigger. The revision plan,
even the revised the revisions to the decision.
I have to rely on them. Is it correct?
Don't forget we get out early tonight, so you could.
Oh, I could still work some. Yeah. We could still work some. Yes, Eric's got nothing else to do. The very best that we can possibly, and I can't even promise it, is that we can get it to you on Tuesday.
Okay. I will promise that if it gets to me on Tuesday, can I put that at Town Hall and have them put it up online or not? Or not? I don't know if it should.
You can do it. When it is a communication from us, it's still confidential, not a public record. But you can decide to make it a public record by putting it online if that's what you want to do.
If I do it. Or does the commission have to do it? Robert's rules.
If you want to do it, the commission can authorize you to do it right now. That's what you want to do.
Do you want to put it on anyway? Just bring it in.
As long as it's written as a draft.
If it's indicated as a draft, would that be?
It will, of course, be.
Yeah.
Yes, just like it is right now. It's got the
word draft.
I'm not taking that off until.
He's not taking that off his computer, that's for sure.
Okay.
So if the commission is agreeable,
yes.
You can put it on the.
Yes.
Okay. You want to vote on that? Or?
No.
Consensus.
Fine.
Consensus.
So if I get it on Tuesday, I will try and put it up.
The only thing is, I just can't promise we'll be done on Tuesday, but if we.
And
we will do what we can to get down on Tuesday.
If you send it through Town Hall, which is, I assume, where you would send it.
No, I'll send it directly to
the commission, except for Jack.
Except for Jack, because I don't have his email address.
Okay.
No.
Then I can take it down to Town Hall and then put it up online, and I will also have a copy.
Or if you don't even have to take it. If who do I give it to? Paula?
Ann Gentile. I'll do it.
Okay.
Okay.
Well, you can just email it. You don't have to take it to her. Just email it.
Would eliminate my excuse for not going down for one day. Come on. I've got one quick thing with the board, with the commission. It's very minor. Okay.
Yes. Thank you. I'll drop those on Monday morning.
I just need to inform you that 201 West Street has changed its address to 201.
Right.
And I've been requested to change all the materials in the town.
Right.
I will campaign kept their number, but not their name.
They're going to be dealing with this for the rest of their lives.
They will. Yeah. They don't realize that it's not only their mortgage and everything.
I know. Oh, wait till their mortgage insurance says that it's been canceled.
And they're not living in the same house that they moved across the street. Yeah. Somebody changed their street number.
That's the first thing that's going
to
happen.
Address from 201 West to 201 West. All the paperwork goes out.
West Street, that's what it used to be. Then they moved it from the coast to Prescott.
Okay.
And they were Prescott, now they moved back to West Street.
And so what happened? So they applied for it and got an address change.
We haven't done engineering, they did.
Yeah.
I asked them to come speak to us about it, because historically the house has always been a West Street address. And they're both former students. One sitting in the second row of middle seat, and the other sitting in a different class, fifth row of middle seat.
Okay.
I have a question, Eric. You sent out a, this has nothing to do with 186, but the other.
All right, guys, thanks.
I didn't see the address. Oh, 174 West Street. This is what goes to the abutters, but there's no mention in here that they have 10 days to make comments. Maybe we should add that.
No, I think
it would be worthwhile to do it so people know they have a time certain they have to.
I think they're told that under the they get the information. I'm not sure.
No, I meant the abutters need to know that right. They only have 10 days to respond.
I hadn't thought about it.
I'm just bringing up.
Probably got
a suggestion.
Yes, it's fine. It's just remembering that do this, and it all gets out. And all the same, like the big thing, you know, and making sure that this is what it's on.
Yes.
And then the telephone number. This is not it. It just was to be. So I will.
Possibly.
I don't know.
Well, you can ask the
doctor. I don't remember reading it.
But it says in our bylaw, right, that they have 10 days to respond.
I think it does.
So I'll move to adjourn.
Yeah.
We adjourn the meeting.
Second.
Yeah. Good job, Jack.
Adjourn.
Thank you.
Adjourn.
Thank you.
9:10.
Well, better than last week.